the moon. Even if you miss, you're gonna land on stars. Good morning to each and everyone present here. With this note, which carries lots of meaning, I would like to start our program. Good morning once again to each and everyone. Your Excellency, Galaxy of Intellectuals, invited guests, teachers, and all my dear friends. Now, I would like to start this program with a prayer. So, here it goes.
Yakundingu Tusharahara Navana Yashu Pravastramita Yavina Varadanda Mandita Kara Yashvita Padmasana their logical and analytical skills,
improve their friends network who are interested in programming, improve their teamwork skills, add a good point in by mentioning in CV, a good recognition, to get a good job in their dream company. So these are the possible outcomes what we have said when you join and learn in programming club. So keeping these goals and ideas, we would like to start up this programming club and inaugurate this programming club in the start of this year 2017. So it is indeed a great pleasure, it's a great honor for us, for all of us, to have in our midst our honorable Vice Chancellor, a distinguished academician. We are blessed to have his continuous guidance and support in all endeavors. He welcome you, sir. I, on behalf of Veritech University and the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering, and on my personal behalf, I cordially welcome our chief guest, Mr. Sudan N. Sanmugasundaram, founder and CEO of HRQ Family Group. Despite his demanding commitments, he has agreed and he is with us. I just called him last month when he was in United States. He picked up the call immediately and accepted our invitation to be our chief guest. We welcome you, sir. We are privileged and honored to have our pro-vice chancellor, Dr. Chandrasekhar. His presence gives us a great encouragement to all of us. It's a matter of great joy and satisfaction for all of us to have his guidance to reach to guiding the destiny of our universe. And we are very fortunate to have our as our director academics, Dr. Kodendra Rao, a distinguished academician and administrator, has always found time to meet every, that is, matters, minute matters related to the growth of our university. And I extend my welcome to our dear directors, Dr. Abu Dhabi's International Quality Assurance Director, R&D, our Inspector Registrar, we welcome you all, sir, madam, and we welcome, extend a warm welcome to our directors and HODs, Faculty College. Happy programming. So now it's time for our inaugural meeting. Thank you very much.
Now it's time for the video inauguration of the programming club.
I would like to call all the dignitaries on the stage. Please, sir. Sameela Satyanarayana, Vice Chancellor, to felicitate.
Dear friends, very good morning to all of you. Our respects and honors to the great visionary, our founder president, Founder Chancellor, Colonel Professor Dr. Vellayan Nagarajan. Our respects are due to our Chancellor, Dr. Sekuntala Nagarajan. Today's our chief guest, Mr. Sudan N. Sanmugasundaram, the founder and CEO of HRQ Coimbatore, and our Pro Vice Chancellor Dr. V. Chandrasekhar, our Director Academics Dr. A. Kodeswar Rao, and the our E-Star Dr. Karna, Director Quality Assurance Dr. Amdehir, Director R&D Dr. Sarsu, and enough mechanical constructions. Dr. Ramchandran, the heads of the departments, faculty friends, and student friends, and who are going to be the members of our programming club, I welcome you all for today's inaugural function of the programming club of Veltech University, initiated by the head of the department of electronic communication engineering, Dr. Mayur Ray. I welcome you all. Let me congratulate Dr. Mayur Ray for initiate this programming club from the department of electronics. And though it is initiated by the department of electronics, it is an important club for all the students of all programs of Veltech University, and it is a common important program to be learned and also create competitive expertise in coding. I hope as our university fascinate doers, this club is fascinate the coders. I wish it, and you all of you know the importance of programming, because without the proper programming skills, there is no way to progress as engineering or engineering professionals. Wherever you work, whatever work you do, a thorough knowledge in the programming skill is very important. And here, I know that many of the students, while entering into the engineering curriculum itself, they have skills, the basic skills in basic programming languages. But coming over here, they have to extend their knowledge in programming, not only the only introduction of the programming C is given here in the first year, but it is up to you how you have to develop yourself with a little inputs that are given from the department. And I know there are very talented students in different disciplines, and there are the fast learners, they are very good coders also. But here, the important of the club is to make everyone fit for this, the program development skills. I know this is the one of the areas where the active learning skills will develop among the students, and some students will be the teachers to the other students. This is the main important of the club, because in the club there are very good talented students. They are sometimes, I can say, in some areas they may be better than us. So here I think you have seen the learning pyramid. The one who can learn maximum is through teaching, through doing. So this is the very good platform for the fast learners who are advanced in these areas, who can make the other students to learn more and do more. Because through this club, I think you can make use of the leisure hours in the campus to do much more towards advancing the skills in coding. I think coding is one of the very important, and we are going on working then you can do many more things. So I love the coding because to all my PhD work and all my students' PhD also, we need to develop the code of our own. Because if you develop your code, then you know where to take the changes to incorporate new development in your research. I hope that we have given only C program skills in the first year, but that too, I surprise why some of the students are going outside to learn again C language, C++. Once you know some basics of the programming and individually you can learn any programming language on your own, because systems are available and instructions are available, help menus available, and also you have your own the supporting teaching community among your own students. This club importance is make use of yourself and teach others. Teaching to others will enhance your remembrance forever, that you please remember. Don't think by the teach you will lose something you are sharing to others what you have known, because you learn more and more. And coding is one exercise when you sit on the computer, you learn more and more, because it's my personal experience. When I had chosen the CMC for my PhD area, I don't know how to create the code for CMC, but slowly I tried to learn from the lab instructor, who is a technician, who cannot know how to write also. Because by learning through him how to operate, what are the codes we have to use, then slowly we develop the code, and finally by seeing my code, and HMT has offered me the managerial position, but because of my interest at my own place, I could not go. But because only I learned through coding only, because doing, and there we have to create some ideas automatically when we are come across some problems which cannot be solved. Definitely, if you have a habit of sitting with the computer, you definitely can learn more and more. And in this club, I request you, though it is initiated from the CSE department, you take it as a programming club for the university, and where I request the head of department, YVL, to be the chief coordinator or maybe the chairman of the club. But here, he has to take the coordinators from different disciplines, and student coordinators or student accredited something. You have to pull some important people into this, so that the evenings you have to take vigorously, and also request some of the teachers whom you feel they are very friendly, and also we have the active classrooms, you make use of them and clarify your doubts in the coding, the programming of things. And because I have left long back, all this I need to have a small exercises, suppose simulation also, because giving the color, making the color background and animation will take, because it's the hitting of the ball reaches other and hitting back, because only the color coding will make it in the background and different things, the simulation will come. This is not very difficult. Once you start doing it, you will learn much more. I really appreciate this club will enhance knowledge. The competition spirit you have to create. Because once the club you have to join, definitely you create lot of competitions, as well in the welcome address, yes, the informed you, that internal coding competition, and also sometimes invite the competition across the institutions also. Now you develop your spirit of coding, definitely that improves lot and lot. I can say any placement office comes here, placement organization comes here by seeing the skills. He cannot go to some other institution for that placement, because whatever the strength and needs you have to take from our university, that level you have to grow. I wish today is the 60 is the best number for our university. The inaugurating on the 6th, I feel it definitely will have a lot of progress, development for this their club. Likewise, I feel the robotics also has having a lot of importance. And also our province is promoting the 3D printer. So the clubs also can, I feel, Ravichandran also will take up one club. That is the main club of the faculty club. The faculty club, we have to promote different clubs to how to develop for the students different activities. I think the reading 3D club or the robotic club, I think once it is started in the Department of Electronics and Communication, but I don't know what happened. Definitely, with the inputs of our directors and ProVC, and also the many of the knowledgeable, experienced, exposed faculty have joined our university, and most importantly, the CDIO, the conceive, design, implement, operate, because that are promoting the project-based education. Definitely, these type of clubs will develop. I see that not the starting of this program, inaugurating program, it is to be very effective implementation and environment. And also, you see that every day some activities to be conducted by this club. And you see that whatever outside is available for coaching should be available here. I can say, the outside, if you go for coaching for any programming language, there are the BSc graduates or some other instructors who are not very knowledgeable. Only they can give these instructions, they can make you to learn what the code, what the syntax. But you are highly intelligent. You make use of this university as a good platform to promote yourself, as a good teacher in the programming course. Good luck to all of you. I thank the organizers for giving the opportunity. I wish a very prosperous and progressive the club for this new year, because we started it in January, and this have taken a festive Sankranti the flower for this club. Good luck to all of you. I wish all of you a new year and happy Sankranti.
We make sure that you will follow your path. Now I would like to call upon Professor U. Chandrasekhar to tell his tale.
Dignitaries of the dais, all the dais, faculty members and students. Wonderful to see this initiative from the Department of Electronics and Communication. So my hearty compliments to Director Academics and the man of the moment, Mr. Dr. Vairavar, for taking this initiative. Fundamentally, programming as a functionality has made this earth flat. What does it mean whether you are a student studying in a Salem University or Seattle? Whether you are from Paris or Papanashnam, it doesn't really matter. As long as you have got proficiency in programming, your skills are going to be recognized worldwide. Just get into any of the top-notch software development companies or the e-commerce service providers, ranging from Flipkart to Amazon to Microsoft to Oracle. 90% of the software development community or fraternity comes from not IITs or MITs or Stanfords, from institutions of our kind. And that has become possible only because of the commitment which has been shown by the Indian students in terms of learning what is the best, what is in vogue, and what is industry relevant. Just before getting into this particular program, for whetting my curiosity, I was seeing what are the skills which make the students globally attractive propositions for employment. And I used two resources, one from the LinkedIn, other one is the Coursera, which is the MOOC's global leader. And in the top 10 skills which are required for global jobs, the first three skills are connected with the programming, the first one is connected with R programming, which is connected with the statistical computing and data analytics, the second one is connected with C# programming. I'm sure the chief guest of the day, Mr. Shanmugasundaram, knows much better than this. And the third one is connected with PHP. So fundamentally, what is the matter that is to be inferred today is programming is no longer is a functionality which is connected with the computer science or electronics. It is really the skill which is required by the global community for creating careers. And you scan any database which has been released by the policy makers over the world. If you really see the 10 skills which are required for positions in the industry for past 10 years, you will see 70 to 80% of them are connected with C, C++, Java, C#, PHP in the recent times. And all these things denote only one thing, that this is a proficiency which everybody should covet and should work with a commitment in terms of learning. And fundamentally, the clubs of this kind really represent the highest in terms of quality of learning. The classroom learning always happens in the mentorship of a qualified faculty member. But the clubs of this kind provide an environment which is extremely conducive to self-initiated learning. And fundamentally, what happens is the learnability of the students gets enhanced by 200% or 300%. If young people like Shanmugasundaram today are the CEOs, which was not a phenomenon 20 years before, it's only because of the fact that they were able to nurture and foster their skills in a very free flowing environment of which clubs offer. So I would like to urge and exhort all the students who are assembled here, which I understand are from the second year, please use the clubs of this kind to hone your skills, to sharpen your skills, to align the skills with the need of the day. And at the end of the day, it's the degree which comes from Veltech University which provides you the identity. And the proficiency which you develop in the programming skills is the one which is going to provide you an opening for you to have a stable and a highly fulfilling job for next 30-40 years of your life. And there is a lot of aspirational profile on the part of the students right from the first semester that I would like to get into a job in TCS or Infosys or Wipro, or maybe in some cases in the company like Facebook. Please understand that it's very much possible for you to go after the fulfillment of these dreams. All that which is required is a commitment for learning. There is a famous saying in Sanskrit which says that Udyamena hi siddhyanti karyani na manorothe. What does it mean? It's not sufficient or adequate to have the aspiration. The aspiration has to be complemented with a very concerted effort. So I would like the faculty of the Electronics Communication Department and also the Computer Science Department to make sure that the clubs of this kind are not confined to the students of only their fraternity. They should be open. The wall should be very transparent in terms of facilitating the inflow of the students from first semester to eighth semester from all the departments. End of the day, if our students are becoming synonymous with the proficiency in the programming skills, which are going to become obvious to the recruiters, I'm very sure the entire ecosystem is going to get maximum benefit out of this particular venture. I also want to submit to Mr. Shanmugasundaram that we have got a very flourishing technology business incubator, one of the very best in the country today. The director concerned is also here. And I would like at least 25% of your talk to be dedicated to the topic of how we can transform the thinking of these young minds in terms of not seeking the jobs but becoming employers themselves by using TVI as a vehicle. Thank you so much and wish you the best.
Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to call Dr. Koteshwar Rao, Director Academics, to felicitate. Sir.
From the chief guest, Shanmugasundaram, HOD EC, Pro Vice Chancellor, Dean, Mechanical and Construction, and other heads, faculty, and student friends. It's a wonderful day here. I was so surprised. It is very quiet. Normally, for a meeting of this nature, we always see students talking. people will speak from here. Something they will be talking something. That shows your interest or motivation towards it. We from the university would like these activities, especially this type of skill oriented, where you are fine-tuning your knowledge and converting towards skill or mixing both to excel. That today there are many training places where people are flocking after their graduation to get these skills. But once you are graduate, I don't know who can teach you. There is nothing like teaching. Even now we are telling we are not teaching, we are facilitating the students to learn. You need to learn yourself. The faculty are the professors, they are only facilitators. These clubs will help you to learn. How they can help you to learn? Through your peers, through dialogue, through discussion. No task is a big task. No task is a big task. If you see any app, any program that is developed, it's not very big, very complex. Provided you spend time on it. The only issue here is spending time. How much time you spend, that decides your expertise. Yesterday we were hearing, we went to Science Congress, we were hearing only one person, I forgot the name, but he is a research manager in Microsoft. He was telling his experience. He was a student of some UC Berkeley. It's a very good university for that matter, like Stanford or Harvard. But what he told, I really liked that point, and it also gave me some memories. There is nothing big in this world until and unless if you are not there, it appears very big. If you are there, oh, this is that's all. I also can do this. He attended one conference, the best conference in that field, which is a dream conference for him. He felt, whether can I publish in that conference any paper? In my lifetime, likewise. But the next, once he attended, he has seen the presentations that they made. He felt like, oh, that's all I can do next year. And he, indeed, he presented next year. People, when we don't really see the things, or when we don't really do the things, they appear very big. Same comes with this Indian Science Congress experience. Yesterday we all went, four directors, we all went to Indian Science Congress, thinking it is very big. Once you go there, it is a waste of time. It's not that great. We did not find really that useful. If you don't go there, you feel, oh, we missed Indian Science Congress. Same comes with the programming. If you don't do anything, it will appear as very big. How to do it? No, it is very complex, man. I cannot do it. I don't have that knowledge. But once you struggle for a week and try to troubleshoot one error, you know that rest is very easy for you. Doing that first step only difficult. Doing that first step only difficult. Once you know how to step, it is quite obvious. Once you know how to cycle, maybe you'll fall down for one or two times. Then you know how to do all. Once you know how to ride the bike, you are the expert in bike ride. You will use the hands and do all the gymnastics. But if you don't know how to do it, if you have not done that, it is too difficult. It is too difficult. Your parents don't allow you. How do you learn the bike? You don't go to the driving school to learn the bike, especially boys, I am sure for that matter. Nobody goes to driving schools to learn how to ride a bike. We take and we try. Maybe one or two times we will fall down, then automatically, after that, all the tricks we do. Same happens in the programming also, very simple. Why I was telling is I remember my experience. After my bachelor's, I got an opportunity in Nokia Research Center in Bochum. They were doing at that time 3G research in 2001. They are doing research in 3G technologies. It is about the OFDM modulation technique. They asked me to write the code in C programming. Then I told, I know, but I forgot. No problem, you write. Then I wrote something, I copied some codes. Then told, no, not this C, Studio C, there is some Studio C, you go and learn and write. But these people, anyway, they are paying, we need to do. After one day or 2 days, oh, this only they are asking, then we know how to manage. We know how to write the code. It is very simple. I have one friend, he is from Pakistan. He used to call, he came to do in a PhD in our group, with our professor. He asked, do you know MATLAB? He told, Matlab? I could not think on the law. But after 3 years, he is expert. MATLAB, he pronounced in Hindi, Matlab. After 3 years, he is an expert. So, the one day we laughed. But after 3 years, he is an expert. So, here, it won't require anything. Why I am telling this is, MATLAB, he did not hear what is MATLAB also, he finished his master's. He did not hear what is MATLAB. But the government sponsored him to do the PhD. So it is a contract between the government, so he got admission. He is telling what is MATLAB. That is a message you need to learn. Here nothing is difficult. You need to do. If you do anything, you can manage. Anything you can manage. That's what today if you see the banks, chairmen, they will be engineers. If you see a big engineering company, there may be arts graduate managing the company. But they will not do just like the words. They study, they work hard, they learn the game, they learn the basics, they'll do it. If you can do that, nobody can stop. That's what our Provisi was mentioning. Today, to work in the big companies, you don't need to study really in great universities, whatever we are calling them as the great universities. You need to prove yourself. You need to prove yourself. If you really participate in any of the competitions that the video is showing, and if you are able to make a mark, you are the best. You are the best, that's all. And people will call you. You don't need to go to the job, they will call you, can you please come and work with us? They are not like fantasies, they are reality. Today it is reality. I hope you all will try to do something. If you want to do, you please stay back. That is the first fundamental you need to do. That boy who told Matla, he used to, what these people are laughed. Every day he won't go out, he will stay in the lab only. He will eat those breads, white breads. In the night, he will stay in the lab only. Complete night he will stay there only. Morning he will go. Because if you don't know the German, he will not speak with others. So morning he will go, night, complete night, again he will come at 3 o'clock. He made 1 month after that, he knows the game. You need to do that. If you do that, nobody can stop you. If you want to be successful, as a programmer, you need to do it. Programmer doesn't mean whatever the job title as a programmer. Everybody needs to do programming only. You cannot talk like us and kill the time and get the salary. We are blessed for that. But you need to do something. Because at the early stage of your life, you need to do. You cannot simply talk and go. If you talk and go, they will not give you money. You need to do means you need to work. Please spend more time in the laboratories. We are even open the labs 24/7. At least one room where your programming club is going to be there. You want to hear a request that you want to stay through the night. then we are very happy. Even we can post one staff, non-teaching staff to stay in the line today also. We will be very happy for that. Okay? I hope you all will do it good. You make this club as a vibrating. Sir, you see, they are also starting this robotics. They have sent some faculty. Robotics lab also we are going to establish. Through that robotics club also, IIT Bombay, they awarded some A grade.
Yeah.
E and something. So they are starting. I wish the department will do much more to make the students realize their dreams. And students also work very hard to realize their own dreams. Thank you very much.
Sir, now I'd like to call my colleague Shravya to deliver an introductory speech on the chief guest today, Mr. Sudhanan Shanmugasundaram.
It is a privilege of introducing our chief guest, Mr. Sudhanan Shanmugasundaram, founder and CEO of HRPU Coimbatore. He is an entrepreneur, mentor, technologist, speaker, and food and fitness connoisseur, preaching on how to stay healthy with Indian food wisdom. He is currently the founder and CEO of HRQ, a global HR tech startup based out of Indianapolis, US, with markets in India and USA. His team of 24 plus people is helping companies find their talent and job seekers search for the best opportunities. He is launching another entity, Mintly, focused on building marketplace for sales professionals in finding jobs, getting content, connecting with salespeople and training. An entrepreneur by heart, he has his roots in Coimbatore. Unable to bear the frustrations of finding a good talent and also realizing the huge skill gap problem, Sudhan laid the foundation of the startup HRQ. Sudhan completed his engineering from Sri Ramakrishna Engineering College, followed by MS in Computer Science from North Dakota State University. After that, he started working in SAP Consulting for 10 years while launching startup in e-commerce, SAP and social media. While working, he also pursued hybrid MBA program at Kelly School of Business, IU. That proved the way for the fourth startup, HRQ. After finishing MBA, Sudhan got himself enrolled in Columbia Business School, where he completed his executive education in personal leadership. Apart from running his startups, he is also a motivational speaker and a mentor to startup Indianapolis. He is also actively involved in Indian startup ecosystem. It's an honor to have you, sir. Thank you.
Sundaram to deliver the speech. Sir,
the technologies. It's amazing, isn't it? So if you have that kind of a feature in any car, you can avoid many accidents. Isn't it? Let's go for the second one.
We spend so much of our lives driving from place to place. To get where we want to go? Since 2009, our team at Google has been developing fully self-driving technology and testing it on real city streets every single day. Until, after more than a million miles, we were ready to take a big step forward. In 2015, we completed the world's first truly driverless ride on public roads. No steering wheel, no pedals, navigating everyday traffic.
Well, I've never been in Austin, Texas. Now I'm driving in Austin, Texas. It's a profound experience for me to be alone in the car. A very important segment of my life was cut away.
This is just the beginning. We're looking ahead to a new way, a better way for everyone. Say hello to Waymo.
So this is driverless cars. So this future is coming. You know, it's already in the US and it's slowly coming to India. And in India we have this, you know, the traffic, massive traffic. And I'm sure, like, you know, they will figure out a way to have this technology. Like how 5 years back we didn't have Ola. Right? Nobody knows about Ola. Right? Ola was a copy of Uber. Nobody knows about it. But now we see that, you know, that invasion of technology is happening, which is in a good sense. Like we have to take it in a positive way, anything and everything, right? So the point is, like, now, if, the reason I played these two videos is that how we can connect the artificial intelligence, how we can have a massive impact on every one of us lives in the future. So as a student of second year, is it second year? Right? So obviously, you know, everybody cannot develop this similar driverless cars or any technology, but there are many applications, you know, many, you know, features you can add on, you can bring in into this kind of technology. You know, Amazon already started using drones, you know, drone to deliver the packages. It's already, they have tested in the UK market, and India, I think it's banned so far. Eventually, you know, after a few years, it will adapt to it. Okay. So it's becoming global. So like sir said, sitting here, you can achieve anything in the world. And we are so fortunate, very lucky, be born to this age. It takes only 2 years to build a billion-dollar company. You know, 1980s, GE, took them like more than 25 years. You can do it in 2 years. So it's an exponential growth is happening. So if you look at, like, there are many technologies, you know, driving us towards the future, you can pick one of them. You know, you start the programming club. You can pick AI, for example. Because the reason I like AI is, like, it's an amazing. You know, I mean, we're gonna sit next to a, you know, maybe a robot or maybe a, you know, AI human, you know, agents, assistants that can help us. It comes with that. I mean, obviously, in any innovation, right? It always comes with problems. Then somebody develops a solution. Then comes another problem. It's a repetitive cycle. Okay. So I develop something, you figure out, okay, there's a gap in that, you come up with a product or solution, you start selling it, you build the company, then there's somebody else come and find a flaw in your system, he will build a product or something. It takes the cycle. You're all part of this ecosystem. So speaking about the programming languages, right? The first thing is, like, no matter what, you can pick any damn language, you know. I mean, you can be, like, you know, C#, Lisp is another language, you can take Python, PHP, you can achieve anything. The fundamental thing is, you have to do your homework. See, a few years back, I went through a very, very tough time in my life. Very tough time. One of my mentors told me three things. He said, if you really want to be successful in life, like other successful people, you have to do three things. Number one, get up early in the morning. Number two, read books. Number three, exercise. You can take any person in India, anywhere in the world, you'll do three things. So once you start following this, you can be from any background, you know, you can be farming background, whatever the background, financial background, doesn't matter. Because a lot of successful people did not have any financial background. That's where you have this, they call, fire in the belly. See, when we select our candidates for our team, we don't look at their academics. We don't look at their, what background, which college they look. We look at, do they have the app? Okay? Because you can develop a programming, any tool in 3 months. You can learn a language in, doesn't matter. You can pick it up. But do you have that? Do you have that to do the homework? When you say homework, when you're working, like, in the morning, when you go to college in the morning, right? Morning hours, you go back in the evening. So that, from 6 in the evening and 6 in the morning, that determines who you will become. Because you are doing, anyways, everybody is studying. So you're all studying your semester exams, you pass the exams, you take the grades. But what extra you're doing, that's going to differentiate you from the rest of the people. It is very important. Three things. First is purpose-driven life. You have to have a purpose in life. If you don't have a purpose, you just like we are all, you know, going with the crowd. It's like, you know, people say standing in the ATM crowd, right? ATM, you know, take the money. No, we are all standing again, joining the queue. Figure out, okay, instead of wasting 2 hours standing in the ATM, I don't want to waste my time. Rather, I give somebody the tips to, you know, get me 2,000 rupees, I'll pay extra 100 rupees. Get me that. You see that too? It's like you can clearly, once you have the purpose, second thing what happens is you can prioritize. Once you prioritize that, third most important, productivity happens. If people, what happens, oh, I want to be productive. You know what productivity, right? So you're trying to achieve your effort in a minimal amount of time, that you can do more. Right? So people confuse it, but you need to have the purpose first. And next comes the productive. So how many of you, I want to ask you this, how many of you really want to be successful? So rest of them want to be failures? They want to fail? You can be honest, because we want to have an interactive session, because I value my time, I value every one of your time. Can any one of you, I will pay you 1 crore, can any one of you buy me 31st of December 2016? Anyone? So time is the most valuable currency. You cannot buy time. People confuse time with money. Money you lose today, you can gain tomorrow, but no time. So the time you are here, the second is you are lucky actually. You have a lot of things you can do, make use of the time. And it's amazing to have a programming club actually. You know, you can collaborate with the people. You collaborate with your friends. You can start building, pick up a problem. Okay? So if you take artificial intelligence, if you want to use Python, you guys have done with Python? Programming language? Okay? You can, yes or no, yeah, that's fine. I mean, it's an open conversation, okay? If you don't know, just go and find out. Nobody knows everything. Nobody knows everything. I don't think, you know, number one, if I say something, what others will know, doesn't matter. When I'm gonna die alone. Nobody's gonna come with me, right? It's a simple, even my mother will not come with me. It's a simple, straightforward concept, right? You know, no question about it. So, you focus on you. How can I be better than yesterday? Ask yourself, how can I be better than yesterday? If I did these things yesterday, I didn't do well. Be honest. Be honest about yourself. You don't have to, you know, satisfy your professor's needs. You know, they'll guide you, they'll support you. But you have to be honest with yourself. And then write it down. Where I'm strong, where I'm weak, where I have to improve. It could be any programming. You know, it could be anything, right? I mean, but the point is, like, you know, if you figure out, okay, this is where I'm making a mistake, this is where I need to improve. There's always a knowledge available. You have internet available, you have people available, you have resources, you have professors. Everybody is there to guide you and support you. Don't miss this opportunity. And the most important thing, if you don't like something, don't do it. Simple. If you don't like something, don't do it. Don't waste your time. Save your energy for something you want to do. Now can I speak in Tamil? Oh no?
Tamil?
No.
All people, all same people are
aware. So we have to speak in English.
English,
okay. So always remember, okay, if you follow what you want to do in life. Okay. So some people are not really good at academics. Okay. Some people are really good at like a practical thing. Some people are really good at like a teaching. Whatever it may be, right? You follow what you want to do. Okay. And then there are courses available, right? You can pick up a mini programming language. You can connect with people, students like you studying in a university in MIT or studying in Stanford. They have open courses, free courses available. When we were studying, we didn't have anything like that. You just have to go to the library and get the books and read it. You know, 10-12 years back, but now it's different. I was thinking, like, if I was like you, I would have liked to jump in and then build a true company just like that. Because you understand, right? The opposites are there. So when the semester exams are there, when the practical, you take care of the part, but also spend time on what you want to do. It could be like only academics. It could be like a programming level. Or if you think I want to be in arts, or I want to be in, you know, like a sports, whatever it may be. Fail. You will fail. You will fail in your attempt. There's no question about it. Don't be afraid of failing. Okay? Once you have the fear of failure, you are emotionally drained, you will not attempt it. Unless you fail, you will not succeed. You can't expect Sachin Tendulkar to play century every time, right? Virat Kohli, right?
Dhoni.
Yeah. So I want to, because the reason is that interaction happens, like you open up, okay? Because when I was a student like you, I've been forced to sit in a seminar where they come and talk about current trends in, you know, job opportunities, and then we'll be sleeping on the last, you know. You don't want that, okay? You value your time, you always value your time. It's very important. Okay, you say, this is my time, this is my life. Okay? This is the time, and you put a value to it. Say, if you are making 10 lakhs per annum, for example, if that's your salary you want to make, or 5 lakhs, right? You divide by 365 days, divide by hours, you put like, what's the value for an hour? What's the value for 1 or 10 minutes or 1 minute? Okay, so you value your time. My time is this much value, and I want to prioritize and spend the time with the right people who will take me to the next level. Can you do that? It's possible, right? So, how many have a dream to build companies, entrepreneurs? Can you feel my friends? Let's give a round of applause.
I'm Shravya from Second Industry Department.
Okay.
So, I have a dream of building a company. I have an idea about Internet of Things.
Okay.
So I thought of developing about it.
Okay. Why?
It's like, I have seen many of my friends and also all of my family members who are working in software companies, and almost all of my family members are software engineers. And I don't want to follow that path. I don't want to work under someone. I want to say, create something new. I want to show world that there are other things other than software engineering. There are even other careers which are more successful than software engineers, because now software engineering has been a trend. So I don't want that. So that was my dream. So building a new company.
Okay. That's it. Good. I think this time here, I think she has a clear path. She wants to. She has a dream in mind, right? So what happens is, I'll tell you one thing. Like when I was in 7th standard, okay. So my first book I read was about Honda. Soichiro Honda. Okay. So it was actually a blueprint for my life. Okay. So I was from a very, very, very normal family. Okay. But I know that I want to be like him one day. Okay, I know that he's decided. Okay, but he laid out the plan, like how we struggled and how we became with the biggest company, one of the largest engineering companies, automotive in the world. So once you have a thing in your subconscious mind, okay, it will take you. What will take you? Universe will take you. If you notice, like, right, people who suddenly become actors, right, like in 30s, I can take example, one actor like Shivakarthikeyan, for example. You all know, right? Most of you guys know about it. Suddenly, like, you know, he doesn't one day, right, okay, I became an actor. No. Somewhere in his life, when he was a kid, something inspired him to become an actor. Just, it gets into your subconscious mind. Only you will know that. Okay? So, once you start developing that, feed that, put water to it, it's like a plant. Start putting water, the plant will grow. So eventually it will take you in making the decisions. You will make sometimes bad decisions, that's okay, but it will take you there. I'm telling you, I've experienced that, and I felt that 100%. So no wonder that this person, she will become a successful one day, she became an entrepreneur. There's no question about it. And there are so I was talking about this, you know, the entrepreneur clubs here. You know, you can part of it, you can engage, you can work with the startup community. So you guys can start when you are in second year, when you do an internship in a startup, you will understand so how the startup works. Okay? The startup lifestyle is different than working in a corporate job. Completely different. Okay? Unless you are passionate about startup, you will not fit for the startup. The best part is your growth is very exponential. Going with an abstract idea, okay, say for example data structures, typically we call like binary algorithms, binary search, right? So those are all outdated stuff. You pick a problem that you are facing in your real life, okay, and figure out a way to solve the problem. And then you start as a mini problem, simple problem, okay? And once you see that, get the feedback from people, how they write about it. And engage other students, friends, faculties. Once they start liking it, then you can start developing a bigger one. That becomes a problem. Every companies that we see now started with nothing. Simple, okay? So what we do is, we normally look at, Infosys or Wipro or Wipcard or Samsung. But if you look at their history, they all started with a very, very simple idea. Okay? The more you simplify, the more you keep it simple, it's more easy for everybody to use it. Everybody to buy it. So I think, like, as a programmer, if you want to be really a programmer, you look at an outside problem and try to solve the problem using the technology. It could be like a PHP, it could be looking at like a electronic, if you are doing a sensors. Okay. Say for example, when I go back to that first video about Tesla, can you tell me like how Tesla was able to, the car was able to predict the accidents? Anyone? Sensors, right? So it takes time, but you can, once you start building the frameworks, okay, you have the hardware platform and then you have the software on top of it, then you can start experimenting. It takes time. Okay? Nothing happens immediately. You have to be patient. Okay? So once you do that, you can start, you can do it sensors, for example, bike accidents. So how many accidents we have in Chennai traffic, right? You can come up with a way how to sense it, and then maybe sense it in the hand. You figure out. Okay? But the important part is start. What happens most of us is we don't start. Unless you start, you don't know. Okay? So we call in startup world, fail fast. Okay? Number two is like fail often. Third is fail cheap. What it means is, you try different things. Okay. For one. Number two is, like, you know, you make mistakes. Third thing is, time and money, invest in building. So you can validate that idea. And that, once you do as a project, you can implement as a, you know, as a, when you do this project, you can write a paper on it, pick for research publications, you can file a patent on it. Then it becomes a company. Then you see, you know what? Oh, my feature isn't ready. Why should I go and work for an MNC? Any questions, guys? And this side is like a... I'm trying to get answers from you guys. What's happening? Is you guys understanding, or is it something like a, I have to communicate more? Yes, please. No, tell me. Anyone? We'll take one question from this side. Okay. Having this voice, Dangal, right? Dangal. See, now the voice is like, once you start a movie, it's like, how is the movie? It's good? So you know that, have you read the book about that? You should read the book about the guy who wrote the book, the hero wrote the book, right? So if, what do you learn from that movie? Anyone? So if you look at, right, everything comes down to, you know, do you have that passion? Passion is very, very important. Okay.
I take this opportunity to thank our management, Vice Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, Director, for the motivation towards the inauguration of this programming club. Whatever. So the first move, what we have planned as part of programming club is, right? So we would like to start classes after Pongal, right? So the class hours will be on Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday, right? So it will change according to the interest of students. Now we can plan on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, after hours about 30 minutes. So the first move what we planned is, we would like to, the students who would like to register this programming club. So we are going to launch a website, which a link will be provided in our college university website, right? So there is an application form you can fill in, you can submit. So those who are registered will be given a DVD comprising of all kind of open source softwares related to EC as well as IT, right? So I see that all the students. When they enter engineering program, when they join a university or college, they first seek a laptop from your parent. I want to do something. But I have noticed nothing is happening in the laptop other than songs and moves. Out of my experience, I have seen that the students are compelling their parents, and parents who are of poor background come and ask me, sir, my son or daughter, requesting me, yelling at home, I want laptop. Then I ask them, what is the purpose of that? They do not have any answer, but it is very catchy to have a laptop at hostel or room. Do not know what to do with it. Right? Even that class, when I go to second year or third year, I tell about some software, they do not know. Right? We have a LabVIEW center of excellence here, they do not know what to do. Right? So, now, my first plan is to make use of a laptop, right? But just in the first, you do install all the software, right? Have a feel. Slowly I'm going to push it. Kindle interest among you all. Feel what is coding. Pleasure in coding.